Morning. We're in Commerce City, Colorado. Oh, it's a little chilly, but it's nice. Sun is out. Only a light breeze. So I guess I'd call that brisk. We're leaving here in a couple of minutes to go get our load. Which is not very far away. Maybe 2-3 miles. In Denver. Place I've been to before.
Proceed to the higher line and ramp.
All right. Okay. Locking me in. I was pretty surprised to find yesterday that this TA here in Commerce City had more than doubled the number of reserve parking. And by reserved, I mean you gotta pay to park there. Yeah, they made a whole lot more places that you had to park at. But I guess it's a seller's market. There's just not enough parking in the Denver area. You know, that there was another pilot. In fact, we're gonna go right by where that pilot was. They shut it down. Don't know why. What is this guy doing? Steering wheel holders, as some people have taken to calling them. And by some people, I mean other truck drivers. Because that's about all they're good for, holding the steering wheel. Every industry has its unique names. Let me rephrase that. Every industry has derogatory names for some people within the industry. Noobs, FNGs, steering wheel holders, Swift rejects. Everybody's got a name.
Jesus.
feeling I should have gone this way. I-70 is a parking lot. A shuffling parking lot. Right is where that pilot was and the blue beacon. What the hell are they doing? They're drilling something. I wonder if they're drilling a, what do you call it? Well, monitoring one. I wonder if there's some kind of environmental hazard or something. Got it shut down. I have no idea. We've got our load here at this first place. Now we're going to roll on to the next place. Thank you. traffic. Gotta wait for traffic to clear. Time when we get done at our next pickup, I think I might like to double back and come to this park, had to hit this Walmart. You can generally get in. Whoa, they made some changes. What's with those barriers? No more big trucks in there? Side effect is by going this way, we get to drive on the interstate for a little bit. About 1 mile or less. Yeah, we're getting right off on the next exit. Thank you. same exit we take when we go to our drop yard right up the road here. And when I used to drive for Central Refrigerated, I used to get off on this exit because they had a terminal up here. It's not a very big one, but it was a terminal. You could go there, you could park for the night if you needed to. They didn't have any real facilities. They had some maintenance facilities, limited. But you could also go in and take care of paperwork, stuff like that. But I suspect since they were bought up by Swift, I'm guessing that they probably don't have that facility there anymore. We'll see in a minute because we're going to drive right by it. Must have some drop the hook stuff going on here. Who knew? Guess we'll park on the side here. Walk in and check in. Okay, we're ready to go. We've got our second load. that heavy. Yeah, we're less than 23,000 pounds. We're good. Back down 76 to Denver so we can cut over and pick up I-25 to head north to Fort Collins. Calls for around 70 degrees, and it is really close to 70 degrees.
I show 69
on the truck. I-25. This is what we're passing under here is that 470. It's a kind of a bypass. It's a toll road though, and you gotta have a special transponder for it. Kind of crazy. Stop up here. You know, I had coffee and breakfast this morning, but not since. Gonna stop. It's still about 25 miles up the road. Gonna stop at that Petro there. See if I can't get a bite. Something quick. Check out all the antelope. Hope you can see them. Over there on the left. Huh. There's some nice looking critters. Let's see if there's any more. Nope. I don't see any more. We're getting ready to roll out of Colorado. Into Wyoming, and this is typically where it starts to get windy, right around here. So we'll see if it's windy in Wyoming. Welcome to Wyoming. We'll be here for the rest of the day. Just rolled into Laramie from the south, and we're gonna get on Interstate 80 right up ahead. But first, before we do that, we've got to go through the port of entry. This is one of those places that don't even have a signal. You just got to come in if they're open, and they are open. So we're gonna go in. don't have a reader board here. I just have the red light, green light. Kitty jumping up. Open the window so I can hear in case they say something. Looks like we're good. I can see green light in the mirror too, so. Alright, let's welcome to Laramie, home of University of Wyoming. I did not know that. So we're going to go up here, get on the interstate, go down a little ways. Got fuel, got parked, and we have time to do some chores. Fixing to head in and do some laundry. And yeah, gonna do some laundry. It seems like I just did laundry, but I guess I need to do it again. We're at the Petro at Laramie, Wyoming. We didn't cover a lot of ground today, 145 miles and some change. However, it was still pretty much a full day. Got up early this morning, got to my first pickup, I don't remember what time, I guess it was about 9:30 this morning. So we didn't cover a lot of ground, but we spent a lot of time getting loaded at multiple places. So, it's been a full day, easily 8 hours anyway. Hey, kitty. He's mad at me. And he wants to get up top, but I got all my stuff up there off the bed because I had to strip the bed. So, he's not happy with me. Too bad. All right. I'm going to call it a night. Actually, I'm going to call it laundry time. I got to get inside and get that going. Actually, I already threw my laundry bag outside the door. So I need to go. And so if you like the videos, please subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And please share these with your friends and family on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for riding along with us today. We will do it again tomorrow, except we'll drive all day tomorrow to Crantsville, Utah.